welcome to a really glorious evening here in England. The stadium is almost full to capacity, and they, like you, await tonight's match between England and Scotland.
Well, I don't know, there's something special about floodlight matches. You just get that bit more atmosphere. I used to thoroughly enjoy them. So the crowd noise seems to get louder, and it seems to lift players somehow. And so I'd be very disappointed if we don't get a good game tonight.
Paul Gascoigne. There's Ferdinand. And the shot causing the goalkeeper a little trouble.
Well played.
McKinley! Paul Scholes. Gary McAllister. Colin Hendry. Billy McKinley. Colin Hendry.
And the ball is over the sideline for a throw. Made that look easy. Nicely held up.
Paul Gascoigne.
The score still 0-0. We're just coming up to 25 minutes gone. The pressure subsides for a moment. Throw it. Nice control.
Shearer!
Well, it's not easy to get clear-cut scoring opportunities from corners because, you know, everyone's back goal side. They're supposed to be picking up one-to-one on the marking situation, but that was an excellent cross and really stranded one or two of the defenders there, got in between them, and there's the goal.
And there's the breakthrough. 1-0.
McAllister!
Gareth Southgate. Ian Wright. Les Ferdinand. Billy McKinley. John Collins.
McGeist! Lambert!
Well, it was another great, powerful run, wasn't he? Surged past his marker and then really unleashed a great shot that looked the kick.
That takes the score to 1-1.
Paul Scholes.
McAllister!
We'll be right back. God's precious water.
Rascal, some of those metal apes are still running around back there.
Yep, Ninjas. We still have work to do. Come, Digit. We still have work to do. Digit, we still have work to do.
Ooh, I detected a hotspot, Rascal. Check the map. Water's low. Hello, help. Hello, help. Clear.
Ah, God's precious water. Come, Digit. We still have work to do.
Still running around back there.
Come, Digit. We still have work to do. McQueen!
How many hostages do I have to kill before you satisfy my demands? I want Dread.
Dear Dread! If I see any other judges, you won't believe what happens next.
We need more time.
Come on.
If I dropped a candy wrapper, he'd
be here by now. He thinks he's so good. Come on in. Take me down, Slime.
He's already put 17 judges out of action.
He's overrun the place.
Dread!
Say hello to
Mr. Mayor. He's next. You got 5 minutes. Remember, I got enough firepower to take out 50 blocks.
We're working on his identity, sir. Nothing yet.
Dread?
Face is familiar. Can't give it a name.
Trying to remember. On your way there. Take out anything you can, Dread. You'll have to rearm as you progress.
One of the judges reports of possible android activity.
Then be careful. A number of justice personnel or citizens could still be in the building.
Thank you.
do you know, Joe?
High explosive.
What?
You're going down, punk.
Level cleared.
On your marks.
Go!
Arr! Yikes, oi, avast there, matey-o! Oh, 'tis a fair sharp of wind as blows past the scudding sails, or else there ain't no evo in the sea biscuit, me blighty-o!
I'm sorry.
Oh, sorry about that. I thought you were a sailor.
All salty sea phrases aside, do you actually sail anywhere interesting?
Oh, aye, lad, aye. We go to the sunny continent of 4X. Sun, surf, sand. Sun, surf. Prawns, sand, sun. And more surf. Lots more sun. And rather persistent jokes about sheep, for some reason.
Yeah, well, let's forget about the sheep jokes for now.
Oh, I wish I could, believe me.
Grief! Look, can I get passage aboard your ship?
Oh, can't be done, my old wantabe shipmate. I'm only taking the living dead on this trip. Special civic arrangement.
See you later!
Discworld 2. Demo. Only the dead escape. Your goal in this demo is to get out of town, dead or alive, so to speak.
Let's just leave him alone. A great big ice block! Yeah, now all I need is a martini the size of a bird bath. Yeah, that leads to Mrs. Cakes. Sort of a sense of foreboding here. No, I don't think so. I have a nasty feeling that this skull motif will come up a lot later on. One crystal ball, complete with test pattern. Just snow. Guess I don't know how to work it. A closet, just the place for the odd skeleton or two. An ironing board. I never use them myself. A wooden dummy. Hey, its arms are almost as dainty as mine. Try as hard as I could, I doubt that I could break an arm off. I don't really have any use for these. A dressmaker's pair of scissors. I doubt whether that would have much impact. Try as hard as I could, I doubt that I could break an arm off. So this is the dead collector, huh? When I was a lad, I just used to collect butterflies. I suppose it's just a matter of scaling up. Oh, lovely, a cartload of corpses. Still, I suppose it's nice to get out for a bit of a ride in the fresh air.
Bring out your dead! Luxury post-mortem transportation services. 5-star service, best cadaver relocation agency in Ankh-Morpork. Highly recommended service. Bring out your dead. Dead, sir?
Dead? Of course I'm not dead. Do I look dead?
No, hard to tell sometimes these days, sir. It's just that if you're dead, then you're stuck in trade. Our post-mortem travel service offers dozens of very exciting internment locations. Have you considered it at all? All the advantages?
Advantages? What advantages could there possibly be?
Well, lower clothing bills, no more overheads for food, for winter fuel, lower rent.
Lower rent?
Well, the dead don't move around much. You might say that they don't need as big a set of digs. That's just a little undertaker's joke, sir.
I'll keep away from them if I were you. Otherwise, you'll end up a stock in trade. So, where do you transport your corpses?
Oh, well, it used to be all mountains, you know, scenic locations. Very cold, you see, so the customers enjoyed it for longer before all their bits fell off. But you should see the place we've just found now, sir. Beaches, hats with corks, and blondes with these huge, straining, pink, oil-smeared...
Yes, but how do I get there?
Well, you'd have to be dead, sir. We've got the entire season's passages already booked.
Look, are you telling me that I have to be dead in order to qualify for tourist travel?
Well, yes, sir. But it's a very reasonable option. We let you take all the luggage you want.
Why is that?
It's all classed as carrion baggage, sir. That was just another little undertaker's joke.
It's a good thing you have a captive audience. Why not just tell me how to get to this holiday location of yours?
Just a death certificate should do it, sir. It's the only way to tell these days. Got one, have you?
So, you need a death certificate just to qualify for foreign travel. In many ways, death's a small price to pay for getting out of this place and starting new life somewhere else. Well, that's enough of this conversation for me. Granny Weatherwax. A tough lady, this one. Best to let her get the beauty sleep she so obviously needs. Slops. I don't think we ought to examine this one too closely. Ooh, it's all cold. I wonder what he uses it for. A Bunsen burner. What is a Bunsen, anyway? And why would you want to burn one? The city mortician. I wonder if this is what he wanted to be at school. How'd you learn? I mean, you start off small with goldfish and so on. I mean, it's a necessary job, don't get me wrong, but it's a... Oh boy, it doesn't sound like a number one choice, that's all I'm saying. I've forgotten what started me off on this now. I think I've been catching too much of that embalming fluid. I wonder if he caters for takeaway. How does one get to be declared dead round here?
Simple, sir. Just lay down on that slab. When a cold mirror won't cloud with your body's breath, and there's no detectable pulse, then we can safely declare the individual to have passed beyond.
Even if they're still walking and talking?
I've had to relax those criteria, sir. In the current situation, it pays to be flexible in your definitions.
What is it that you do exactly?
Well, I issue all the death certificates, make sure they're really dead, that sort of thing. We can't have people being buried alive, you know.
I should certainly say not.
Yes, there'd be hell to pay at the graveyard. All the undead would be on me like a shot. Live bodies in a dead-only area. Wrongful zoning of designated areas, the lot. Very touchy lot, the undead.
What have they got to be snobby about?
Been there a long time, you see. They're getting very touchy with this epidemic and everything. When you've got yourself a nice grave, good view, patio and barbecue pit, well, you get a bit iffy when a lot of newcomers suddenly turn up. Only to be expected.
Be seeing you then. Just the thing, a cold, hard slab of stone, and what's more, it's unoccupied. Alright, look, I'm feeling a little bit dead. And so I thought I'd better just pop along and see you.
Right. A very wise decision, if I may say so, sir. Now, we'll do a few little standard tests. Firstly, I'll check your breath, see if it clouds up this mirror. Bad news, I'm afraid, sir. You still seem to be in the land of the living.
Are you sure?
Afraid so, sir. I can't really offer any hope. You might go on like this for years and years.
Well, I suppose I'll just have to go on then.
Never mind, sir. You never know what tomorrow might bring. Chin up. For all you know, you might be dead in no time.
Hello again. Look, I'm virtually sure this time. I've been feeling a little bit dead most of the night. But I definitely felt myself pop me clogs a few minutes ago outside. Would you care to just take a little look?
Firstly, I'll check your breath. See if it clouds up this mirror. Okay, now I'll check your arm for a pulse. Bad news, I'm afraid, sir. You still seem to be in the land of the living.
Are you sure?
Afraid so, sir. I can't really offer any hope. You might go on like this for years and years.
Well, I suppose I'll just have to go on then.
Never mind, sir. You never know what tomorrow might bring. Chin up. For all you know, you might be dead in no time.
Well, the one saving grace is that the loss of the poor fellow's cranium probably didn't interfere with his thinking. What, walk around here carrying a troll's head? A vile smell? An ambulatory vile smell? Yes, well, that's brought some life into my day. So this is the infamous foul old Ron. You know, there are some personalities so stunningly horrid, so utterly breathtakingly awful, that they actually transcend the mere physical frame of their owners and stand out as an icon, a banner of meaning with a life all of their own. Then again, there's also hundreds of grubby old street people like this bloke who just make me want to scratch. Henry Coffin, famous beggar and the man of a thousand nasty coughs and spits. He can hit a spittoon at 20 paces and I wish he'd try to. The Duck Man, I presume. I just don't know how anybody can live with a duck on their head and not know it.
Spare a gold piece, sir. Spare a gold piece.
Look, about this...
What, sir?
Well, it's just... Do you feel any... poultry-ish presence in your life?
No, not that I can say I've noticed.
So you wouldn't say, for instance, that you have a... an unusual choice in hats?
Hats? I don't wear a hat.
Or pets, perhaps?
No, sir. Never keep any pets. They say an owner always ends up looking like their pet. And who'd want to go around in life looking like something silly?
Ah, yes, yes, I see your point. Oh, yes. Nah, don't think I really want to handle this one. Correspondence would be welcomed. See you later.
Spare a gold piece, sir. Spare a gold piece.
A saw. At last, I have seen a saw. Good idea, but not just yet. This should fool him. Hello again. Look, I'm virtually sure this time. I've been feeling a little bit dead most of the night. But I definitely felt myself pop me clogs a few minutes ago outside. Would you care to just take a little look?
Firstly, I'll check your breath, see if it clouds up this mirror. Okay, now I'll check your arm for a pulse. Looking good so far, sir. Just one last test. Your body temperature.
No, wait! Perhaps we can talk about this!
Bad news, I'm afraid, sir. You still seem to be in the land of the living.
Are you sure?
Afraid so, sir. I can't really offer any hope. You might go on like this for years and years.
Well, I suppose I'll just have to go on then.
Never mind, sir. You never know what tomorrow might bring. Chin up. For all you know, you might be dead in no time.
Let's just leave him alone. If it's low body temperature he wants, then it's low body temperature he'll get. Hello again. Look, I'm virtually sure this time. I've been feeling a little bit dead most of the night. But I definitely felt myself pop me clogs a few minutes ago outside. Would you care to just take a little look?
Firstly, I'll check your breath, see if it clouds up this mirror. Okay, now I'll check your arm for a pulse. Looking good so far, sir. Just one last test. Your body temperature.
No, wait! Perhaps we can talk about this! Yow!
Wonderful news, sir. Wonderful news.
Yes? Am I dead?
As a doornail, sir. Finally, a satisfied customer at last. Now then, here's a death certificate, which also entitles you to cut price headstone carving, embalming, and free drinks at the yearly Mortician's Ball.
Mortician's Ball? Doesn't sound like much fun to me.
Oh, you know, sir, once the old embalming fluid starts flowing, of course it kills you in the end, but what doesn't, eh? Well, have a nice death, and please don't hesitate to call round again if there's anything I can do for you.
Phew, a death certificate. Now that I'm decently dead, I can get on with my life.
Well, hop on, sir. We'll soon have you off to a post-mortem holiday. Did I tell you the one about the carrion luggage?
Afraid so.
Ah, well, can't win them all, or any of them, come to think of it.
Thank you.
Discworld 2. Missing, presumed. Available soon.